This is what a usual work day looks like for 36-year-old Aparna Kangni. Depending on the task at hand, she's either segregating, washing and cutting plastic into strips or working the charkha to create fabric, all from plastic waste collected from across the country.
Me ekokari join keli tyavi mala maiti nahota ki baba plastic pasun apan he use karu shakto apan kahitari kurkure che wrappers vagere he ahet. ह्या प्लॅस्टिकची कटिंगही माहिती नव्हती मला. पण जेव्हा इकोकारीत आली तेव्हा मी कटिंगपासून सगळं पाहिलं, त्यामुळे आजूबाजूच्या ह्यांना पण सांगितले की बाबा ना, ह्या रॅपर्सपासून आपण कटिंग व्यवस्थित केली तर ह्या रॅपरचा आपल्याला उपयोग होऊ शकतो.
At Ekokari, where Aparna works, a social enterprise based in Pune, women like her are trained in the craft of handloom to upcycle single-use plastic to be finally designed into fabric-based products like bags, cushion covers, planters, and other accessories. With an in-house team of 25, the enterprise has estimatedly upcycled close to 20 lakh plastic bags since its inception in 2020.
When we started Ekokari, so the major source of waste was coming from the waste pickers, because at the time the awareness and everything, or people were not aware what Ekokari is doing. Over the period of a year or so, what has happened that I think 90% of the plastic is coming from the citizens, because you can see that most of the plastic is actually getting couriered to us. So we get couriers from as far as from Ladakh and Leh. In the east, you can see that some of the parcels are from Nagaland also. And from the south states, we get a lot of plastic from Chennai, Bangalore, Hyderabad and all those cities. And then Pune, a lot of customers who know us, they come and drop the plastic to our doorsteps.
The plastic used at Ekokari, however, is not just any plastic. Multi-layered plastic, or MLP, has been under the scanner the world over. Made using at least one layer of plastic, in combination with other materials like paper, metallized layers and polymeric materials, this continues to be one of the most difficult products to dispose of scientifically. While upcycling units like Ekokari are few and far between, recycling options are complex and limited, and the last stage of MLPs invariably finds itself back into our ecosystem. Why this is particularly worrying for India is because recent studies reveal that almost 40 to 50% of all our plastic waste today is MLP. Lightweight and easy to transport, graphics friendly and suitably built to preserve food products, MLPs are a big favorite with the FMCG and packaged food industries. And from biscuits, chips, chocolates to shampoo sachets and toothpaste tubes, they have crept into our daily lives and seem here to stay.
There are a couple of problems with that, why it is not being recycled or upcycled in a big way. The first one is that volume to weight ratio is completely high. So, for example, a waste picker going and picking plastic across the streets, and if he is completely filling his gurney with these, it might hardly weigh a couple of kgs, not more than that. So, but at the end of the day, they are paid per kg, not per volume. So, they don't fetch any money, so they don't take it. The other part of why MLPs are not being recycled is because there are 3 to 4 layers in plastic, and each and every layer has different melting points. So in the traditional way of recycling, they put it, melt it and make the granules out of it. But with this kind of plastic, you cannot do it because the aluminium foil and everything doesn't melt at the same point.
So this is the packet, the way the packaging looks. If you separate it, you can actually see all of the layers. So on top there is a transparent layer, then there's colorful plastic layers that are different types of plastic, and inside there is a foil layer. And so actually they're all different types of materials which should be handled separately, and to separate it, it's such a major challenge because of which the material is difficult to handle.
40-year-old Supriya Bhadakwar tells us she's been working as a waste picker in Pune since she was a child, in what was then a predominantly unorganized sector in the city.
पूर्वी डेपमध्ये एकाच्यावर कचरा टाकत होते आणि त्याच्यामधनं हुडकून इचून इकायचं इकत होतं आणि पूर्वी असं होतं. मग झालं की असं की ते म्हणजे डेपोला जातो ना आम्ही, तिथं आम्हाला जास्ती काय भेटत नव्हतं, काही नव्हतं. सगळे लोक म्हणजे अशी व्यसनारी होती. तिथं माणसं डेपोला गेल्यावर हाकलून देत होती की तुम्ही कचरा व्यासायला नको म्हणत होती आम्हाला. मग म्हणायची काय बी चोरी करते ती म्हणायची, तुम्ही अजिबात डेपोत पायच ठेवायचं नाही म्हणत होती.
For the longest time, this marginalization of an already marginalized community was fair game here, as it still is in most parts of the country.
Gardens of bhya gade wale angor gade ghalache zoras tyamadi kadhi bhetta kadhi navta bhetat pagar bhetat navte kadhi 100 chote kadhi 50 chote kadhi bhetat navta kay mang ghari upashe marayche mang
o ne ata kachra de kachra.
Taking pains to ensure what they collected through a day brought them some semblance of economic value meant concentrating on high-valued recyclable materials instead of multi-layered plastic. PET bottles or metal waste, for example, fetches an average waste pick of 5 to 7 times that of MLP. It was sometime in the late 1990s, however, that things started to change in Pune city.
In the late 90s, the Pune Municipal Corporation was one of the first in the country to actually issue ID cards that legitimized what the waste pickers were doing in Pune. And over the years, by documenting their contribution to the environment, to the savings of the Pune Municipal Corporation because of the intervention of waste pickers and the health benefits of what the waste pickers were doing, we were able to advocate for their formal integration into the solid waste management system.
Since 2008, grassroots organization Swachh Cooperative, in partnership with the Waste Pickers Union and the Pune Municipality, have built a network of 4,000 waste picker members, most of whom are women.
Every single day, they cover about 200 to 300 properties each, and they collect segregated wet and dry waste from these households. They reach out to about 9 lakh households in Pune city, covering 70 to 75% of the city's properties for primary collection of waste.
Apart from being paid for doorstep collection and from selling recyclable items, since 2019, Swachh, in partnership with FMCG major ITC, has developed a program to buy MLP waste directly from waste workers.
The core principles of our agreement with ITC is to actually use extended producer responsibility principles to benefit the waste pickers and the informal sector workers who have been handling recyclables for all of these years. The idea is that this is a material that previously brought no value to waste pickers and would end up polluting the city or end up in the landfill. Through this project, we are able to actually create a market value using support from the project to buy this kind of waste from waste pickers. In doing so, we are able to not only pick up the plastic that's causing a problem for waste management, but we're also able to pass on that benefit directly to the waste pickers of Pune city. We're currently collecting upwards of 70 tons per month, and we're reaching out to more than 1,000 waste pickers every single month and adding about 500 to 600 rupees to each waste picker's monthly income from the sale of plastic waste.
So far, the project has estimatedly diverted over 1,000 metric tons of MLP, that's more than 20 crore packets of chips, away from landfills.
The main चालू झाल्यापासून ना म्हणजे स्वच्छ लोकांमध्ये सुद्धा कामाला काम भेटले. आता ते मिर्च पावडरची कागद किंवा कुरकुरची कागद बिस्किटाची कागद अजून चटणीच असतात त्याची कागद तिची पार्सल आपण आणतो त्याची कागद ती सगळी इकत घेते ती.
About 5 hours from Pune, in the town of Palghar in Maharashtra, we visit a recycling unit where plastic waste, once collected and sorted, usually lands for processing. 52-year-old Shakti Plastic Industries has reportedly processed more than 5 lakh tons of plastic, 40% of which was MLP. The company has been known to invest in the technology of multi-layered plastic recycling.
हमारा जो सेल है वो प्लास्टिक पैटर्न होता है, प्लास्टिक पर डिपेंड होता है, बट एमएलपी हमारा एक प्रोडक्ट है जो हमने अलग से डेवलप किया है. एक्चुअली एमएलपी हर कोई नहीं कर पाता है, कारण क्या है, इसलिए एक बहुत कॉस्टली है, ये प्रोसेस बहुत लेंदी भी होता है. जैसे हमारे पास पहले एमएलपी आते हैं बेलिंग सिस्टम में आते हैं, जैसे हमारे पास ऑल ओवर इंडिया से आते हैं, स्टेट बाय बाहर के स्टेट से आते हैं, तो 1 टन 2 टन के ट्रक उसमें लोड करके आते हैं हमारे पास. हमारे पास बेलिंग फॉर्म में आते हैं, बेलिंग फॉर्म में आने के बाद उसे हम मशीन के पास अनलोड करते हैं, उसके बेलिंग को तोड़ा जाता है, उसमें से जितने भी रैपर्स वगैरह निकले हैं उसको ग्राइंड किया जाता है, ग्राइंड करने के बाद उसे वॉश आउट किया जाता है, वॉश करने के बाद उसके फिर एग्लोमरेशन किया जाता है, एग्लोमरेशन के बाद उसे प्रोसेस लाइन में लाया जाता है जहाँ एक्सट्रूशन प्लांट बोलते हैं, जिसे जहाँ पे ग्रैनुल्स के फॉर्म में बनाया जाता है उसका.
While MLP granules are developed here to create products like benches, dustbins and tiles, it is a power, water and labor intensive industry. This is what drives most others to process MLPs either through incineration in cement plants or in the waste to fuel industry. The environmental and health hazards associated with both have been a subject of global and national scrutiny.
There are two things involved when we're looking at policies for MLP. The policy stance on MLP has gone back and forth a bit in recent years. There was a call to phase out all multi-layer plastics in the plastic waste management rules. But 2 years later, that was kind of revoked. And the decision was that energy recovery, like end-of-life processing, would be sufficient as means of disposal, of adequate disposal of multi-layered plastics. As it currently stands in the extended producer responsibility draft, the end-of-life disposal, so waste to fuel, plastic to road, plastic to oil, pyrolysis, these kind of end-of-life processing for MLP is considered adequate for extended producer responsibility purposes. There is some debate both nationally and globally about whether these technologies, about the technologies themselves and as well as the impacts of the technology.
Policy intervention, EPR and citizen participation apart, there has been an active call for the phasing out of multi-layered plastic as the only viable long-term solution. But whether that happens or until it does, the answers seem to lie in taking smaller, more immediate steps.
ह्याच्या आधी जो कचरा गाई वगैरे हे असे खायचे वगैरे त्यापासून त्यांचे पोट वगैरे हे बिघडायचं, पण तोच कचरा थोडाफार कमी होतो, आपण त्याचा काहीतरी उपयोग करतो.
आम्हाला नागरिक चांगलं ओळखायला लागलं, त्यांना माहिती झालं की स्वच्छ म्हणून काम करतं ते आणि दारोदार काम करते, कचरा चांगलं घेते ते, वाला सुका वेगळा करतं ते आणि जे पुनर्निर्मित आहे ते सुद्धा चांगलं करतं ते, म्हणून म्हणजे आमची ओळख झाली की असणारे आहेत म्हणून आम्हाला सगळं माहिती झालं. नागरिकांना माहिती झालं की स्वच्छची लोक आहेत ते चांगलं काम करतात म्हणून, आणि हे लोक चोरटे नाही ते काय नाही ते स्वच्छेमार्फत काम करतात ती.